Let it rain on me. Let it rain on me.
Come on, let the sound of worship be released from your lips tonight. Come on, raise it now. Oh, that's good, y'all. Raise it, raise it.
You provide the fire, I'll provide the sacrifice. You provide the spirit.
My brothers and sisters, friends all, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will certainly rejoice and be glad in it. Today is a very special day, and we meet for worship under the theme, Resilient and Strong. Let's celebrate Jamaica 58. Let us enjoy the presence of the Lord, and let us smile a while, give our faces a rest as we worship today. I'm now going to turn over to the praise and worship team, who will come and lead us into worship.
Good morning, everybody. This morning.
Amen.
If it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be here this morning. So we gotta give God a shout of praise. Give him a big up this morning, don't it?
Yeah.
I'm sure this morning that we all can identify with the song that was just sung. God is my all in all. Resilient and strong. Let's celebrate Jamaica 58. And now we are going to have the opening hymn, Hallelujah, Hallelujah. Praise Jehovah. And that will be followed by prayer by Pastor Claudia Ferguson, representing the Jamaica Evangelical Alliance.
Let us pray. God our Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for our lives that we have received from you, Lord. We thank you that you have caused us to be here in this sanctuary, to worship, to honor you, to give you glory and praise. We exalt you. We recognize you as God our Father. And so, God, we have come to worship you on this occasion, to acknowledge your goodness, your grace, and your mercy. Lord, as we celebrate Independence 2020, Lord, we first of all acknowledge you that you have brought us, oh God, through difficulties, through challenges. You have caused us to be resilient and strong. So, Lord, as we come to worship you, we are mindful, Lord, that we acknowledge, oh God, that you it is that has given us, Lord, the strength, the power to achieve all that we have achieved. So, God, as we worship you, we invoke your Holy Spirit. We pray that your presence and your power will be among us and upon us this day. And wherever we are, Lord, in this sanctuary, if we have joined by radio and television, If we are worshiping on other media platforms, we pray, God, that your Holy Spirit will rest upon us so that the worship that we give you this day will ascend to you as a sweet smelling savor. May we worship you in the beauty of holiness. May we worship you in spirit and in truth. So come now, Lord, and tabernacle with us, and cause, Lord, that all of us will be blessed this day. Be with those who lead and those of us who share. May all of us together, Lord, worship you in a manner that you will be pleased. Thank you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Please be seated. It is my privilege to ask the host and senior pastor of this church to bring us the welcome and introductions. And interestingly, he is the immediate past president of the Committee for the Promotion of National Religious Services. Ladies and gentlemen, the Reverend Courtney Gordon.
Thank you very much, Reverend Dr. Peter Garth. Good morning, everyone. Even though the rain is falling, we can still give you a warm welcome in Portmore. And thank God for bringing us together as we celebrate this national Thanksgiving and Independence service, remembering well our journey and remembering well who we are. A warm welcome, kind welcome to everyone who has come from near and far, those in the physical space and those of the virtual community. COVID-19 indeed has made a lot of adjustments to our lives, but no virus, no situation can disrupt and destroy the resilient spirit that we Jamaicans have. And we thank God that despite it all, we are less in the physical, but we are more in the virtual. There are more persons listening to this service and looking and viewing this service than even before. When there comes to us challenges, we turn them into opportunities. Your theme, our theme, resilient and strong. Let's celebrate Jamaica 58. Is very timely, and it tells us of the journey that we have been on, a journey that is punctuated with struggles and challenges, but we believe that we have within us as a people the strength, the will, and the conviction to master our destiny. We at the Portmore Church of God are mindful that the mastery that we have of such destiny has to consider greatly the initiator of every independence and freedom, and that's God Almighty. He has been our sustainer. He has been our sure guide and guard, even as we journey on. We must also be mindful that there are obstacles and adversaries on this journey, but we believe that our freedom is ours, and we must be resilient in claiming it and living in it and resist everything that comes to undermine such a freedom. We too must also recognize that we are a people that must partner together, work together, live together, so that Jamaica will continue on its path of development and freedom. With God on our side, with the will of the people, the Jamaican people, no adversary, no obstacle can stop us to realize this desired freedom. Congratulations, Jamaica. I wish to acknowledge and to salute the following persons who are in our presence, making even our service meaningful and reminding us of this great freedom. Honorable Stedman Fuller, Custos of Kingston, representing His Excellency the Governor General. The Most Honorable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister of Jamaica. Mr. Colin Fagan, Member of Parliament for this constituency, and representing Dr. Peter Phillips, Leader of the Opposition, and Mrs. Fagan. Honorable Olivia Grange, Minister of Culture, Gender, Entertainment, and Sport. Senator the Honorable Thomas Tavares Finson, President of the Senate. Honorable Alando Terrelong, Minister of State in the Ministry of Education, Youth, and Information. Reverend Dr. Peter Garth, Chairman of the Committee for the Promotion of National Religious Services, and colleagues, members of the committee. Pastor Robert Stewart, guest speaker, and Mrs. Stewart. Honorable Jeffrey McKenzie, Custos of St. Catherine and Mrs. McKenzie, parish counselors and caretakers. Councillor Rainier Benjamin, representing the mayor of Portmore. Commissioners of the JCDC and interim executive director of the JCDC, Committee for the Promotion of National Religious Services, Jamaicans watching at home and in the diaspora, brothers and sisters, members of the media, and everyone, welcome to this great service of the people of God, reflecting on our journey, and out of that reflection, celebrating where we are, and out of that celebration, be purpose in our hearts that the journey is not at its end. We keep moving on to freedom. God bless us as we share in this great service. I'm going to ask the praise and worship team to sing for us our usual welcome song from the Portmore Church of God.
Comfortable. And there's just something about the Jamaican vernacular and something about music. When it hits you, you feel okay. And I saw persons doing that little evangelical jig to the song that was just sung. What a marvelous day it is today as we are reminded to be resilient and strong. And I will keep repeating that because after today, as we go along, I want every Jamaican to be saying those words and living out those words. Now we're going to allow the program to flow. And we're going to have coming to us just now in this order. Maylin Dillon will do for us a ministry presentation entitled Oceans. And then we are going to have the indefatigable Minister of Culture, Gender, Entertainment and Sport, the Honorable Oliver Grange. And she will be followed by ministry presentation, His Strength is Perfect, done by Nikisha Jones from Lord Dance Ministry. Let us prepare our hearts for what is coming up just now.
Good morning, everybody. Waters,
Let's hear it from Aileen again. Isn't she wonderful? Prime Minister whispered to me and say, you have to get this young miss into a program. She's going to be a star. God is good. All the time. Honorable Stedman Fuller, Custis of Kingston, representing His Excellency the Governor General. The Most Honorable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister. Mr. Colin Fagan, Member of Parliament for Southeast St. Catherine, am I right? And representing Dr. Peter Phillips, Leader of the Opposition. And also, I must acknowledge the presence of Mrs. Fagan. And at the same time, I will acknowledge the presence of Mr. Robert Miller, JLP MP caretaker for the Southeast St. Catherine constituency as well. In this time, we're balancing everything, right? MP Fagan. And I'm also, at this time, want to acknowledge, I don't know if Minister Terry Long is here. Oh, there you are. Good. Good seeing you. I know you were going to another church as well this morning. You're doing the churches today. All the time, I understand you do the churches, every Sunday. So I acknowledge Minister Terry Long, Minister of State in the Ministry of Education, Youth and Information. I also want to acknowledge the presence of former Mayor of Portmore, Mr. Keith Hines, who is present with us this morning. Reverend Courtney Gordon and Mrs. Gordon, our host, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank them for having us here this morning, and members of the church. Pastor Robert Stewart, our guest speaker, and Mrs. Stewart. Councillor Renair Benjamin, representing His Worship, the Mayor of Portmore. Happy to see you, but I really was looking forward to seeing the Mayor this morning. Parish councillors and caretakers. Honorable Jeffrey McKenzie, Custis of St. Catherine and Mrs. McKenzie. Commissioners of the JCDC and Interim Director of the JCDC, Ms. Daffodil Thompson, other distinguished ladies and gentlemen. I especially want to recognize the Committee for the Promotion of National Religious Services. And I am looking here and I see my permanent secretary. P.S., you're from Portmore too, are you? Originally. So thank you for coming as well. And a special acknowledgement to Jamaicans in the diaspora. We're streaming live, ladies and gentlemen, to the world this morning. And we're also live on TVJ. We're streaming live via Love FM. Brothers and sisters, blessed is the man who preserves under trial, because when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life that God has promised to those who love him. James 1, chapter 12. We mark our emancipation and independence anniversaries this year under the reality that Corona 19 is with us, and indeed with the rest of the world. But what is a more powerful reality is that we Jamaicans are a resilient and strong people. This morning, as I look towards you, I'm saying normally the church would be jam-packed and we'd be rocking and rolling and enjoying the praise and worship. But we are constrained. We have to keep our distance, and in a way, what it does, it forces us to be so prim and proper. But I'm asking you this morning not to hesitate to praise the Lord. Don't be afraid to say hallelujah. And so, Buju Banton says, and this is a winning song, I'm a Jamaican, resilient and industrious. So what better theme for this trying time than resilient and strong? Let's celebrate Jamaica 58. A people's resilience is demonstrated by their ability to cope with stress and adversity and bounce back to a previous state of normal functioning. Resilient faith is a quality of faith that enables us to see through trouble and trials and to emerge stronger. We, without a doubt, have been proving ourselves capable of measuring up to what is required in the face of the pandemic. We have done much better than many of the large countries in the world. And I want us to this morning thank the Jamaicans here and abroad for being resilient and strong, and to thank our Prime Minister for leading us in a very powerful way to ensure we can overcome. As Buju Banton says, it's not an easy road. The word strength and derivatives are mentioned in the Bible almost as many times as there are days in the year. 360 times to be exact. God has certainly blessed us with the strength to minister to others and the strength to overcome. In fact, he has endowed us generously, and that is why we have to praise and give thanks this morning. So then, church, the coronavirus, while it is limiting us, it will not dampen our spirits and cannot stop us from celebrating our emancipation and independence anniversary with enthusiasm and living up to the theme, resilient and strong. Let's celebrate Jamaica 58. We're conducting our celebratory activities in a controlled environment as directed by the protocols that have been established. And so with a small audience this morning, we are happy that we are not restricted to the physical space, but we are also celebrating virtually. Sunday, a week ago, television viewers were treated to the Jamaica Festival Song 2020 final. Everyone was talking about the competition, which saw participation of some of our top established artists, giving the competition a special boost and launching the careers of some of those artists who were not as well known. The songs were great, and by all accounts, the final was a worthy show. Tonight, I invite you to join us on television and virtually as we select the winning gospel song for this year's celebrations. We start at 5:30 on television and will beam across virtual platforms right across the world. Another major highlight is the Spirit of Independence Awards. In these awards, we invite Jamaicans at home and abroad to celebrate our 58th independence anniversary by decorating in the national colors. And so we will have awards for the best decorated business office, the best decorated private residence, the best decorated government office, and the best decorated parish town square. So I want the message to go to the mayor that we are expecting you to dress up your municipality. You may just win a gold award. Participants are encouraged to decorate in the national colors. There is no wrong or right way to decorate. Each competitor is encouraged to decorate using props and decorative material, doing as much as possible to draw the attention of the public. We're also encouraging media houses to feature Jamaican music, showcase Jamaican talent, have discussions about Jamaica, and also celebrate our wonderful culture. As in previous years, the event will be shown live on television of our Grand Gala. But this year, it will not be the Grand Gala. It will be called a Spectacular. And this is being beamed from the television studios and virtually online. I will close as I started. And this is especially for MP Fagan. Be on your guard. Stand firm in the faith. Be courageous. Be strong. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 13. The word of the Lord to us at this particular time, as we celebrate the 182nd anniversary of our emancipation and the 58th anniversary of our independence. God bless you all. Thank you.
His strength is perfect, so perfect. I can do all things. Jesus comes to an end. He hears our humble cry and proves again His strength is perfect when our strength is gone. He'll carry us when we can't carry on. Raised in His power, the weak become strong. His strength is perfect.
His strength.
Everything in this service is lining up so beautifully. Having listened to Minister Grange, I must say that I am extremely proud to be a Jamaican. And I believe that every tissue in us should cry out, Jamaica, 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 resilient and strong. We're going to move our program along, and I'll now introduce the items that will flow. Our next item will be done by Miss Jamaica Festival Queen 2020, and she's going to be leading us, rather, in the national pledge, and that's Miss Kamara Wright. That will be followed by the Honorable Stedman Fuller, Custos Rotolorium for the Parish of Kingston, and he represents today His Excellency the Governor General. After that, we're going to have our Prime Minister, the Most Honorable Andrew Holness, coming to do the first reading taken from the Old Testament, Joshua 1:4-9, and that will be followed by Mr. Colin Fagan, Member of Parliament, St. Catherine Southeastern, who is representing Dr. Peter Phillips, the Leader of the Opposition. His reading will come from 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 1 through 10. Kindly follow in that order.
May I invite you to place your right hands across the left side of your chest. The National Pledge. Before God and all mankind, I pledge the love and loyalty of my heart, the wisdom and courage of my mind, the strength and vigor of my body. In the service of my fellow citizens, I promise to stand up for justice, brotherhood and peace, to work diligently and creatively, to think generously and honestly, so that Jamaica may, under God, increase in beauty, fellowship, and prosperity, and play her part in advancing the welfare of the whole human race. The National Pledge. Thank you.
Reverend Courtney Gordon, Senior Pastor of the Church of God in Jamaica, Portmore, our host, and members of his clergy, the Most Honorable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister, yes, I was going to say Mrs. Holness as well, but she's not here, yes, Mr. Colin Fagan, Member of Parliament for St. Catherine Eastern, representing the Leader of the Opposition, Dr. Peter Phillips, and Mrs. Fagan. Honorable Olivia Grange, Minister of Culture, Gender, Entertainment, and Sports, and other members of the Cabinet. Minister of State, Orlando Terlong. Reverend Dr. Peter Garth, Chairman of the Committee for the Promotion of National Religious Services, and committee members, and other members of the clergy, Senator Tom Tavares Finson, President of the Senate, Costas McKenzie and Mrs. McKenzie, Councillor Benjamin, representing the Mayor of Portmore, members of the media, special invited guests and congregants, a pleasant good morning to you all. Their Excellencies, the Most Honorable Sir Patrick Allen, Governor General, and the Most Honorable Lady Allen, regret that they are unable to be present at this National Emancipation and Independence Thanksgiving service. The honor is therefore mine to represent the Governor General and bring brief remarks on his behalf. And as I looked up, I'm sure I'm seeing Ms. Natalie Nita Headley. No? Yes. His Excellency's remarks. The celebration of the 50th year of independence of our beloved island home, Jamaica, is an occasion for thanksgiving. No matter where we are in the world, our hearts still swell with pride, and a deep sense of nostalgia is evoked whenever we witness the hoisting of the black, green, and gold, accompanied by strains of our prayerful anthem. However, the commemoration of this milestone in our nation's history is not just for the usual festivities. It provides another invaluable opportunity for us to reflect and recommit our hearts and minds to the continuous and crucial task of nation building. The COVID-19 pandemic has changed our lives in many ways, including the celebration of our independence. Most of us have taken the necessary precautions to contain the spread of the virus. However, we still have much to do to minimize the economic impact of this pandemic. The frontline healthcare workers, security personnel, and others have gone beyond the call of duty, and we thank them for their selflessness. their efforts and the government's response have prevented our situation from being worst. So, as we approach our 59th year of independence, we must seek to forge a future where no one is disadvantaged, disheartened, or disenfranchised. Our unique heritage, which unites people from all cultures and races, is a reminder that we must join together in affirming the inherent worth, dignity, and equality of all members of our society. The emancipation of our forefathers and mothers, fought for many years ago, must be guarded, and we must not settle for anything less. Hardships they may be, but the resilience, strength, and creativity of our people will help us to embrace the uncertainties of the future in our journey as a nation. God bless you, and God bless Jamaica, land we love.
Minister Grange, Reverend Guard, you will notice that I'm speaking to you through my mask. Deliberately so. And forgive me, Minister Grange, for breaking the protocol of the program, but I vow that each time I take the platform or the pulpit, that I must remind the nation that we are still in COVID times. COVID still keeping. That you should wear your mask, you should social distance. If you are having events, you should physically distance the arrangement. Wash your hands regularly, especially if you're touching surfaces that you're not certain about. And if you don't have to go out, stay. These measures have worked and they have served us very well. And in saying that, let me take this opportunity to congratulate the churches who have done exceptionally well in maintaining the protocols. The church is an example of freedom and independence, because being free does not mean that you are without responsibility. So the church has shown that they have used freedom and independence responsibly. And that is what every Jamaican citizen should model in this time as we celebrate our own freedom and independence. Freedom is not free. The price of freedom is eternal vigilance and responsibility for our actions. Having said that, the Old Testament reading, Joshua chapter 1, verses 4 to 9. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon, and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country to the Mediterranean Sea in the west. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. Be strong and courageous, because you will lead these people to inherit the land I swore to their ancestors to give them. Be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the law my servant Moses gave you. Do not turn from it to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep this book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. The word of the Lord.
Happy that this church service, National Church Service, is being held in the constituency of Southeast St. Catherine, of which I'm the Member of Parliament. And I want to thank Minister Grange for her encouragement. Surely Fagan is strong and will stand firm. The reading of the scripture is from 2 Corinthians chapter 2, and I'll read from verse 1 through to 10. And I'm reading on behalf of the opposition leader, Dr. Peter Phillips. So I made up my mind that I would not make another painful visit to you. For if I grieve you, who is left to make me glad but you whom I have grieved? I wrote as I did, so that when I came, I would not be distressed by those who should have made me rejoice. I had confidence in all of you that you would all share my joy. For I wrote you out of great distress and anguish of heart and with many tears, not to grieve you, but to let you know the depth of my love for you. If anyone has caused grief, he has not so much grieved me as he has grieved all of you to some extent, not to put it too severely. The punishment inflicted on him by the majority is sufficient. Now, instead, you ought to forgive and comfort him so that he will not be overwhelmed by excessive sorrow. I urge you, therefore, to reaffirm your love for him. Another reason I wrote you was to see if you would stand and test and be obedient in everything. Anyone you forgive, I also forgive. And when I have forgiven, if there was anything to forgive, I have forgiven in the sight of Christ, who you, for your sake, in order that Satan might not outwit us, for we are not unaware of his schemes. Here is the reading of his holy word. May he add his blessing.
Brothers and sisters, the Most Honorable Prime Minister, Andrew Holness, and Member of Parliament Colin Fagan, both demonstrated that the word of God should not be muzzled or masked. And so they read without masks, and we are grateful for that. We have come to a very crucial point in our service when we are nearing to hear from God's manservant. Juliet Grant is going to do a musical selection with Jesus, I Will Make It. And after she sings, the next voice that you will hear will be the voice of Pastor Robert Stewart. It would take me a long time to go through his profile, so I will just summarize by saying Pastor Robert Stewart hails from Frome, Westmoreland, and that he is a graduate of the University of Technology, and he's also a graduate of the University of the West Indies, and a graduate also with a Bachelor of Theology from Andersonville Theological Seminary, as well as a Master's in International Management from the University of Phoenix. He's a mathematician, and so it is going to be very interesting to listen to his sermon. He succeeds the late, great, and very venerable Custos Rotulorum of St. Andrew, Dr. the Honorable Carmen Stewart, as he's now the pastor at the Pentecostal Gospel Temple. Pastor Stewart is married to Beverly, and she's in the service today. Welcome. And I want to say that they have been married since 1973. Do the calculations. Marriage works. And so, my brothers and sisters, the final thing I'll say is that he is also a justice of the peace for St. Andrew. And now we invite Juliet Grant, our songbird, to sing, and then after that, Pastor Robert Stewart.
Good morning, one and all.
In this world I'm passing through. On my journey, my downs seem many, and my up seem only a few. I've been up on the mountaintop, and I've been down in the valley too. This road I travel is not an easy one, but by faith I'm moving along. For with Jesus I'm making, I know my needs He'll supply. And though I be cast down in pain and shame, before me, and he's trying to block me with fear. The way gets hard and rocky, and it seems my life end is so near. Then I remember those Hebrew boys in the fire, he did not let them die. I'm so sure Jesus walks with me. So neither will I. For with Jesus I'm making, I know my needs He supplies. And though I be cast down in so much pain and so much shame, and this world
pleasant good morning and happy Emancipendence to my brothers and sisters in the audience, to those of you watching on live stream, those of you on TVJ. Greetings in the precious name of Jesus. I must thank the Jamaica Pentecostal Union Apostolic, the leadership, for recommending me to speak to the nation on this day. This is significant for me because one of the leading persons in the formation of that union was the late Bishop Dr. the Honorable Carmen Stewart, who pastored me for over 40 years. I would also like to take this opportunity as a Jamaican citizen to say how proud I am of the government's handling of this pandemic we are faced with. The decision to make economics secondary to the protection of its citizens could not be an easy one, especially that summer is here and the silly season is nigh. This was a team effort, and the role of the Prime Minister, the Minister of Health and Wellness, the Minister of Local Government, the Attorney General, the Chief Medical Officer, along with the input from the opposition, is commendable. And I'm proud of the team that we in Jamaica are leading the way, even for the First World Nations. As we prepare to celebrate 58 years of independence, 182 years of emancipation, here are a few quotes we may want to bear in mind. In the best of Bustamante, selected quotations, 1935 to 74, Sir Alexander Bustamante said in 1962, and I quote, "Independence means the opportunity for us to frame our destiny and the need to rely on ourselves in so doing. It does not mean a license to do as we like. It means work and the law and order. We can make independence a great success if we can choose as our individual motto, service, not self. And we are a country without a conscience. Quotations by Michael Manley, Prime Minister Michael Manley, speaking about corruption, said, "We dare not allow corruption to become entrenched in Jamaica society. For if we do, we have permitted by our own default the planting of a bomb that sooner or later will bound to explode." He went on, "If we look about us, we see the lengthening shadows of 1,000 small corruptions creeping across the landscape of our nation. This is monstrous, for it is not the evening of our history. It is the morning, and the shadows should be forming the other way." End of quote. I juxtapose these two quotations because they are not mutually exclusive. If we serve for service's sake and not for self, it will be harder for us to become corrupt. In July of 1846, the British Parliament passed the Sugar Duties Equalization Act. This was a disastrous year for the Jamaican economy. Under the act, there was a stipulation that preferential duties for sugar from the West Indies would be phased out over a 6-year period. After 1852, all sugar entering Britain would be charged the same duty. It meant Jamaica, along with other British colonies, using free labor to produce sugar, would lose the protection that was in place. We now had to compete with Brazil and Cuba, which still had slave labor. Suddenly, we were faced with an economic crisis, but we survived. This was due in part to the great role played by the church, in particular, the Moravians and the Baptists. Now, that was long before my time, but my reading of history confirms that we are resilient and strong. The slave passage across the Atlantic did not stop our indomitable spirit. Our forefathers came to the realization that salvation is only found in our Lord Jesus Christ. They were quite aware that our spiritual beings living in a material world, that's who we are. Brothers and sisters, the spirit comes first. Matthew 6:33 warns us, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Jesus is still the answer. Between 1950 and now, I have seen how resilient and strong this nation is. Who can forget the latter half of the 1970s? The war between the oil-producing countries that led to the formation of OPEC. Then we read in Exodus 17, 18, 8 and 9, "Then came Amalek and fought with Israel in Rephidim. And Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men and go out, fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand." I want to say to us Jamaicans, there is a tendency among the newer generation that us older folks should be part. But observe that whilst Joshua, and this was his first mention in the Bible, he was first mentioned fighting as a general in the valley. But Moses understood that whilst a physical war was raging in the valley, there ought to be a spiritual war being raged on the mountaintop. And we older folks need to realize that even when we can't fight in the valley, we ought to be down on our knees crying to our God to defend Jamaica, because Jehovah Nissi is still alive and well. Israel was in slavery to Egypt for 400 years. Joshua was a great general, born a slave in Egypt. Joshua was 40 years old at the time of the Exodus. He was one of the 12 spies who went to spy out the land. At 80 years old, he received this commission. He died at 110 years, but he was a man of prayer. He was a man of courage. He was a man of faith. He depended upon God. He had leadership enthusiasm. He had fidelity. He's a type of Christ in name and work. As someone has commented, Joshua shows that a man of average ability may become a leader. He received this call, not in flaming letters across the sky, but from an old man who knew God and knew Joshua and saw that he was fitted by God to be a leader. We are faced with a pandemic. And I've never seen a time like this before, but I'm saying to us, be strong and have a good courage, because the God of Joshua is still the God of Jamaica. Be strong and of a good courage. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. None of us have ever lived through an international shutdown of non-essential businesses before. We have never seen a time where schools and churches and most everyday types of businesses were closed. We have never had social distancing rules for 6 feet of separation before. Many around us were out of work, out of money, and afraid. This is uncharted territory. Pastors and leaders do not have all of the answers. Nobody does, but that is okay. The COVID-19 pandemic is teaching us so much. What an opportunity to learn. This is a time to learn about faith, a time to learn about love and having a sound mind. It is a time to learn about the peace of God that passes all understanding, to trust the providential care of God. We should tell others of the countless times God has brought us as a people through crisis, through famines, through floods, and through pestilences. Tell everyone about God who has shown his faithfulness to you. Offer them hope. This pandemic shall pass. If we present Jesus throughout this ordeal, we will not be ashamed when this storm is history. We are believing God for a coronavirus comeback. I'm believing God that is going to be better. It was in 1950 October when Hurricane Jig passed near the west of our island, and heavy rains caused flooding in central and western parishes, which created sinking land in some communities. The town of Lucy in Hanover was turned into a lake, and the town of Cave Valley, a major commercial center on the border of St. Anne and Clarendon, was flooded with waters reaching heights of 50 feet in some places. All crops in the land were damaged, with banana cultivation suffering the heaviest loss. But we survived. We were resilient and strong, for our God is able. 1951 August, Hurricane Charley came, and the reports told us that 154 confirmed dead, 2,000 were injured, 9,000 were left homeless. The Kingston Harbor was damaged, and 5 large vessels were driven ashore. Banana and other fruit crops were destroyed. Coconut plantations and citrus groves perished. But we survived. We were resilient and strong. Following the passing of the hurricane, heavy rainfall came, and as a result, numerous landslides across the island. 80% of Moran Bay was destroyed and several communities were wiped out, but we survived. We were resilient and strong. Can I tell you about Hurricane Hazel? It affected Portland and St. Thomas. There were widespread rains, but we survived, for we were resilient and strong. Hurricane Janet in 1955 caused island-wide rains, which lasted for 10 days. It led to the flooding all over the island. Port Moriah was declared a disaster area, but we survived. We were resilient and strong. Hurricane Flora in 1963, but we survived, for we were resilient and we were strong. How can we forget Tropical Storm Gilda in 1973 that left hundreds of families homeless, but we survived, for we were resilient and strong. 1979, the June flood. I will never forget that June flood. I woke up the morning to go to do an organic chemistry exam paper. And when I got up, I heard Alan Magnus on the news saying that a church on Windward Road is washed away. And when we went down there, our church, the Pentecostal Gospel Temple, was lopsided. A part of it was in the McGregor Gully. And the school at Windward Road, the principal, with whom we have a very good relationship, offered us the school for service. But after one service, the congregation decided, no, we are going right on the spot. And we went back there and we started having services. Go to Windward Road now and you will see the beautiful edifice that adorned Windward Road. We were resilient and strong, for we believed in Joshua's God. We believe in the God who created the heavens and the earth, and he is still our God. And it was after that that the Office of the Disaster Preparedness was set up in 1980. And for me, this was a show of our resilience and strength, for we little, but we talawa. And I must hurry on, because I know there are folks in here who have other things to go to today, but I must tell this congregation and the world. In 1966, Lee Kuan Yew, the Prime Minister of Singapore, said, and I quote, "People are not aware of Singapore's vulnerabilities. What they read and see is number one, number two, competitive country, number one seaport, number one airport, number one airline, and so on. Sometimes they complain that we are driving people too hard and making life too stressful. So why not settle for number two or number three or four? But it does matter, for if we are not near the top in competitiveness, there is no reason why we should have a seaport or an airport or an airline, or indeed why there should be a separate independent Singapore. It is as simple as that." End of quote. I say to us today, as we strive to be the Singapore of the Caribbean, let us not forget our Christian heritage. Let us remember the men and women who, because of their Christian groundings and faith in Joshua's God, fought and prayed for our emancipation and independence. We cannot continue to grow our children without a godly reference point and expect to remain resilient and strong. If we sow to the wind, we will reap the whirlwind. It was Calvin Coolidge, after World War II, the Republican nominate, our vice president person, who says on July 27th, he cautioned that the country against abandoning its social contract with its warriors. And here he says, "The nation which forgets its defenders will itself be forgotten." End of quote. Psalm 19 verse 7 tells us, "The wicked shall be turned into hell, and all the nations that forget God." Daniel 11:32 tells us, "And such as do wickedly against the covenant shall he corrupt. but by flatteries. But the people that do know their God shall be strong and do exploits. Jamaica, if we continue to hold on to the God of Jerusalem, the God of Israel, the God that has brought us to independence and 58 years beyond, if we continue to put our trust in Him, we will remain resilient and strong. We cannot sell out to the first world nations. We must live as an independent nation. I believe we have enough resources in this country to make this place an example of pearl in the Caribbean. We must remain resilient and strong against the forces from the north, against the forces from the south. Righteousness still exalts a nation, and sin is still a reproach to any people. And as the old hymn reminds us, as I come to a close, faith of our fathers living still in spite of dungeon, fire, and sword. Oh, our hearts beat high with joy when here we hear the glorious word. Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we will be true till death. Our fathers chained in prisons dark were still in heart and conscience free, and blessed would be their children's faith if they like them should die for thee. Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we will be true to thee till death. Faith of our fathers, we will strive to win all nations unto thee, and through the truth that comes from God, mankind shall then indeed be free. Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we will be true to thee till death. And then the final stanza, faith of our fathers we will love, both friend and foe in all our strife, and preach thee too as love knows how, by kindly words and virtuous life. Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we will be true to thee till death. I say to all of us, let us be resilient and strong. Let us not forget our heritage. This is a Christian nation. The Baptists and the Moravians came and they fought against slavery and all these things so that we can enjoy freedom today. So I say to us, do not throw the baby with the bathwater. Let us be resilient and strong. Let us be resilient and strong through Jesus Christ our Lord. For in Him we move and have our being. God bless you in Jesus' name.
I can at this time only quote the words of Friedrich Nietzsche. What does not destroy me strengthens me. We will now have the praise team leading in the congregational response, "You Are My Strength." And immediately following that, we'll have the representative of the Jamaica Association of Full Gospel Churches doing the prayer of intercession, the Reverend Helen Ann Brown.
You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other reaches me. You are my strength. Strength like no other.
Adjustment to facilitate the Prime Minister. So at this time, we are going to invite the Honorable Olivia Grange, the Minister of Culture, to come, and it is customary that there is a presentation to the host church. And so I'm going to turn over now to Minister Grange.
Thank you so much, Reverend. At this time, church, I would like to, first of all, to specially acknowledge my close friend, the President of the Senate, Senator Tom Tavares Finson, who I omitted to acknowledge earlier. Ladies and gentlemen, you'd never forgive me. I'm asking Reverend Gordon to step forward. Prime Minister, I'm inviting you to join us up here. And I'm also inviting MP Fagan. And to balance the scale, I'm inviting Robert Miller, along with Alonda Terrella, who they all represent Portmore. And I'm inviting Mrs. Gordon, please join us. And this is a special presentation. And the mayor's representative, please join us. Come on this side, Robert. Come on, right beside MP Fagan. Come on. Let's give them a big round of applause. To the pastor and members of Church of God in Jamaica, Portmore, we thank you for hosting the 2020 National Emancipation and Independence Thanksgiving Church Service on August 2, 2020. This is from the Ministry of Culture, Gender, Entertainment and Sport and the Jamaica Cultural Development Commission. And it is also being presented on behalf of the Committee for the Promotion of National Religious Services. We thank you so much for hosting us, Prime Minister. It's my pleasure for you to make this presentation, sir, to Reverend Gordon and his wife. Thank you so much. Thank you, PM. And I just want to remind you all this evening at 5:30, please tune in to the Jamaica Gospel Festival Song Finals. You can vote via text or you can vote via the app for your song. In addition to that, on Independence Day, August 6th, which is Thursday, we will have a flag-raising ceremony starting at 4, which will go live. And at 5 o'clock, we will have our spectacular from the arena, which will also go live. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Reverend, for accommodating me.
Praise God. It's a tremendous time to pray an intercessory prayer for Jamaica. And it's a very important prayer because of where we are as a nation. So God, I give you thanks. I give you thanks. Lord, I lift up, first of all, mighty God, the Church of God in Jamaica, a pivotal instrument of anything that happens. that invisible force, oh God, that gives this nation a wind in its sails. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, the mighty name of Jesus, that your church will arise. I pray, God, that every standard that is listed in your word will be held fast by your holy church. God, I commit this church in Jamaica to you. I pray, oh God, in a time like this, that the church will become a forerunner. I pray you'll lift us from our lethargy, God, and lift us to become a forerunning instrument, not only in the nation of Jamaica, but globally, oh God. I pray we'll be a light on the hill for the global church. I commit this church to you. Father, I commit next the government of Jamaica. Mighty God, I thank you for the government. As a people and as a government, over time, we have done well. We have traversed numerous transitions without violence. Thank you, God. Lord, we have believed in the ballot. We thank you, God. Mighty God, we commit to you, the government. We commit for wisdom. We ask for great wisdom in a time when, God, you have to be extremely savvy to traverse what's happening globally. We pray for maturity, God. We pray for a non-aligned spirit. Mighty God, we can't afford it in this time, Almighty God, to be curry favoring, but that God will be totally non-aligned, totally looking to you and on behalf of the people of this nation. God, I commit that to you, Lord. We pray, God, that even though we have done so well, the things that remain you will cleanse. We thank you for the message you gave your speaker. And God, we pray you'll cleanse the nation of corruption, not just the government, but the people. Father, we commit ourselves to you for a cleansing. We pray you'll be like a wind blowing through, O eternal God. And I pray that your instrument that should be the barometer of righteousness will stand for righteousness in these matters. Father God, we pray for the people, the wonderful, resilient people of my great and powerful nation. Lord, how I pray that we'll be a strong people. How we have been strong over time, God, traversing the hurricanes, fighting for freedom from slavery and from various oppressive things. God, I pray we'll continue to be strong. I pray, God, we'll continue to fight for our rights. However, God, I pray for wisdom. I pray you'll teach us to fight with love, to fight with maturity, to fight without violence. Because, God, there is a fight that does not have to be physically violent. So, God, give us wisdom. Teach us, Lord, that when we tear down our house, we still have to live in it. And so give us wisdom as a people. Lord, we know it's a time of the end. I know that. But, God, even in this time of the end, I pray you'll give my nation, our nation, greatness. We're looking to you to hear this prayer today, Lord, and to do mighty things in this nation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us commit today to be resilient and strong as we face all the challenges of today and the difficulties of tomorrow. Let's all stand for the national anthem.
Father, bless our land.
continue to bless Jamaica, land we love. Please be seated. I will now, at this time, hand over to the host church for announcements and other important matters.